Hey guys, salut mes amis, ok hallo gubar, Maxime here. Here's another Noob to Pro tutorial. This time I'm going to talk about network settings. It's important to know what the network settings do and which ones are the best. Since some of these technical terms can be hard to understand, I'm going to explain them as friendly as possible so that hopefully everyone understands. Let's begin with the command rate. To simplify the meaning, rate decides how much information you're downloading from the server you're playing on. When you watch a YouTube video and you increase the quality, you might have issues watching the video. But if you lower the quality, you can watch the video without any problems. But you won't get the best quality. It's pretty much the same with CSGO. To find the best settings, you first need to know your internet speed. I'm using speedtest.net, which is a perfectly fine and working service. What you need to look at is how fast your download speed is. Your upload speed has nothing to do with this. Since I'm from the best Shutbule IKEA country in the world, I'm getting these dope results. But I know that most of you are not from Sweden, which is why I made a list here to show you what settings I recommend depending on your download speed. I've increased the requirements to give you the most stable solution for CSGO. If your download speed is 8 megabits per second or more, then use this to get the best server experience. If your download speeds are lower than 2 megabits per second, I recommend using this value anyway. Now, I want to go through update rate and command rate. These commands are closely connected to the server's tick rate.
Maxime, what's a tick rate?
The tick rate is a frequency which checks if something has happened in the game. When you increase the tick rate, you're telling the server to work faster. This means that the players on the server will need to keep up with the new speed. If the players can't keep up, they will encounter performance issues. That's also why matchmaking is using a tick rate value of 64. This is sort of like the safe zone, because most players will not have any issues running the game here, and it will still perform well. However, servers created by the community are usually set to 128, because it's obviously more accurate, but it's heavier for everyone. The best settings, in my opinion, is to set both CL update rate and CL command rate to 128. If you look at your net graph, you can see if you're using the best settings for the server. Ah, much better. Now let's say you're standing still and you're getting peeked by someone. In this scenario, you encounter something called interpolation. So what is interpolation? Let's say the enemy moves like this. Without interpolation, the movement of the player can look very choppy or jittery. Interpolation will go back in time to make the movement smoother and more sexy. But that also means that interpolation will not show you the player's real position, which is bad if you want to wreck noobs. What I would recommend is to adjust the settings so you're getting the lowest interpolation possible. Use CL interp 0 and CL interp ratio 1. If you're experiencing some packet loss, you can raise CL interp ratio to 2 or 3 instead. Next up, client-side prediction. In short, it means that if you're moving around or shooting someone, you're doing it before the server knows that you're actually doing it. If you have a very bad ping and you shoot a player, you will see that the player gets hit much, much later. Just like one of those old, low-budget fight scenes. I recommend having CL predict and CL predict weapons on 1. Even if you don't hit your shots the same time the server knows about it, it's still better to be able to move and shoot from your screen without any delays. Another thing that really helps people with high ping is lag compensation. If you don't have lag compensation and you're lagging because of your wireless connection or your slow internet, it could look like you're shooting a ghost. Lag compensation works in a really cool way. When you shoot a moving player, the server wants to be a bro. So what the server does is goes back in time to compensate for the fact that you're lagging and then counts it as a hit. So basically, you should always enable lag compensation and prediction. Make sure CL lag compensation is set to 1. These are the most important network commands and now you're ready to go. If I were you, I would save these commands in a config so you can execute everything at once. I'll see you guys in the next video. Go bananas!